Today, we're going to talk all about the mature haircuts that work. You guys love this topic on my channel. It's one of my number one most viewed video on the entire channel. Every single time I make a mature haircuts video, you guys absolutely love it. You have so many questions. You have so many personal concerns. So I thought it'd be a really good idea to do a live stream all about the topic so that we can chat and hang out and really form this really strong community that we have here. You guys are my glam fam. I always say that. And I'm so excited to be live with you. Today, you don't just have to listen to me ramble on, and you guys know I get so nervous at the beginning of every live stream and I talk and talk. You guys get to meet someone who is a phenomenal hairstylist in the flesh. It's not a virtual live stream. We have my hairstylist, Charise, in the house. Come on. We need a clapping track.
Hi, glam fam. How's it going out there? I'm so excited to be here.
You guys, she knows. It's my glam fam, and they're my glammas. We probably have some glammas in the house. If there's a glam in the house, leave it in the comments section below. You guys, where are you watching from and what are you drinking? Okay. Ooh. Every live stream we ask where they're watching, what they're drinking. We're not drinking anything.
You know what? Actually, I had a coffee and I left it at work. I just made myself a coffee in a to-go cup.
Yeah.
So somebody's enjoying a, or not enjoying. Someone's got to throw it out for me. I do this.
I was thinking of bringing us wine, actually, but then every live stream at the beginning, I'm like so like flustered. I'm like, it's not going to work.
I know. And then everyone would have to see like our wine teeth. We'd have to go with white next time.
Next time we're going to do some white wine.
Ooh, some people have wine.
Yeah, we have. Oh, I'm a glamma. Hey, Margo. Guelph coffee. Oh, we have someone local in the house. We almost never have anyone local in the house.
I love that for us.
Yeah, that's exciting. Okay, so why don't we start a little bit with our community questions? You know what? Before we do that, we got almost 50 community questions, which is really exciting. As you guys know, I love prioritizing the live chat. That's really important to me because I love that you guys are on. So we're watching the live chat while we are answering other questions. If you have a really good question, put it in the live chat. We do have a moderator in the back room who's reading all of the comments and she'll pop them up as they go. So don't feel like you have to wait for a pause in the conversation to put in your question, okay? If you have a really good question, put it in now. But I want to first start with a little bit of housekeeping, okay? So let's get to know—
Is this the rules?
No, I want to get to know you a bit because my audience doesn't know you yet. Okay, yes. So—
We did go viral last week, though.
I was just going to say.
On Instagram.
So last time I got my hair cut in my bob, I filmed it all and I made a video and it went viral. It got
so good.
Almost 4 million views, I think.
Yeah, we're almost at 4 million and a lot of opinions, too, about such a beautiful classic haircut.
Yeah, I'll leave that there. I told Charise, when you go viral, once you get to 1 million, that's when the crazy comments come out.
Yes, do they ever. I find it so entertaining, though, connecting with strangers on the internet. You know?
Well, that's what we're doing today. Yeah. Although they're not strangers. They're
this
my
family.
This is
the glam fam.
This is my glam fam. So how did you, what's your history with hairstyling? How did you get started?
Oh, that's a great question. And I feel like being in your space here, I identify with it so much because I don't know about you, but like, I loved hair from the beginning, like my whole life, like as a young girl growing up, loved beauty. And I feel like when I was a teenager, I thought about becoming a hairstylist, but it almost seemed like this is going to sound so ridiculous. I can't believe I'm saying this at 36 years old, but I actually thought it would be like, oh, that'd be like taking the easy way out. That couldn't be challenging because naturally I'd be so good at it.
You know,
and then I went to school and I realized actually it's really hard. So yeah. I've been styling hair, doing hair cutting, coloring 18 years. I've done a lot of education and done fashion week a few times, dabbled in lots of different spots in the industry. Now I'm a salon owner and that's been so much fun. I love it. I got a great little team.
Yeah. So Charise owns an amazing salon in Ontario, Southwestern Ontario, named Thatch and Fringe. I'm going to leave the contact information for that in the pinned comment below because there's so many questions and so many questions that I get. how do you find a great hairstylist like that? Even in our viral reel, I said, this is what happens when you trust your stylist. And I basically just told her, like, do what you think is going to be best for my hair type. And then I showed the end result and we had thousands of questions. How, but that's not how every hairdresser, how did you find her? Where? And I even had emails, where is this woman? So I'll leave her salon linked in the pinned comment below. If you guys are anywhere around Southwestern Ontario.
Local, come check us out. We'd love to see you. We'd love to meet you and cut your hair.
Yeah. Tell her, just do whatever you want.
Yeah.
Okay. So here we go. So let's start a little bit with some community questions, because I always prompt you guys in the community board. And I really love that you spend time reading the community board and asking questions. So a really great, great hair question is from R. Melinder, and it's hairstyles for rounder faces that are not too short or too long.
Yeah, I can totally speak to this. I identify as somebody who has a round face. I'll get up close so you can see, but I do carry a lot of the width in my cheeks. And I think, like, when we talk about, like, a round face, like, what constitutes a round face, right? And it's when your cheeks and here is, like, the widest part of your face, and maybe you kind of close in a little bit up here at the top. And I think when it comes to, like, speaking from experience myself, I like to avoid, if I'm looking to not draw attention to my round face, I like to avoid putting really hard, blunt lines on the widest part of my face. That doesn't mean that you can't pull off a blunt bob when you have a round face. It just means you really want to pay attention to where that perimeter is sitting, right?
Yeah.
So Gabby, I'll use her as an example. She sits just below her chin. If I would have brought it up shorter to her chin, it would have emphasized her chin. And she doesn't have a round face, but it's just an example of where that line sits, where it's going to emphasize. For myself, I really like lots of layers around my face. I think it keeps it nice and soft. I think having a curtain fringe here, I'll show you guys in here, this corner, I feel like opens me up a little bit, brings my cheekbones out, kind of gives a little bit of a contour. I'm always trying to contour. When you don't have a lot of bone structure, you're always trying to, you know, fake it till you make it, they say. But lots of layers and softness.
Yeah, that's something that I said.
Yeah,
totally. I did a whole video on round faces. Mm-hmm. And I think that when your face is round, right, you want to, in theory, elongate it in the eye. Now, all of this is theory, and makeup is this mm-hmm. way, and hair is this mm-hmm. way. And I really don't like talking about it in that way, because I don't think that a round face is less attractive than a diamond face, and a diamond face is less attractive than the perfect oval face and all that BS.
Yeah.
You know, I'm just, like, not into that.
Yeah.
And so I think every face shape is beautiful, but certain haircuts will draw attention to certain things. So if you feel like your face is very round and you desire a leaner face, then you can lean it out with hair. You can lean it out with makeup as well. But when it comes to hair, it's exactly what you're saying. Like, Charise has a middle part, so that's drawing attention this way, which is closing in the face. Mm-hmm. And then you have your curtain bang, which is closing in the forehead. Whereas if her hair was all back and tight, all you would see is the roundness of the actual forehead, because there's nothing like,
yeah, you will like literally never see me doing a slick back look in public. I love it for people. I'm envious of people who wear their hair like that. But for me, it just doesn't feel like I'm showing off my favorite assets. You know what I mean? I'm not putting my favorite features on display. So doing this, I feel like it's like, ooh, my eyes.
Yeah. And that's the same even for, if you think about really long faces or very oblong faces, like I have a very long, skinny face, and that's why I like my hair short, because it brings my face up. It lifts it up. And whereas when I have it really long, like here, I have this really super skinny face because the line is dragging it out. And bringing that into our topic today, into like mature haircuts that work, as we get older, so many people say that you should go shorter, which I completely disagree with. Mm-hmm. I don't think you should go shorter or have to go shorter by any means, unless you want to and feel great in that style, but you should go contoured.
Yes. Doesn't it drive you nuts, Gabby?
Yes.
When women are like, oh, am I too old to wear my hair this long? And I'm like, no, I want that phrase out of people's mouth. You are never too old to wear your hair longer. Really, age and hair length do not dictate each other.
Exactly. It has.
I'm so passionate about that.
I am so passionate about that too. And I did this makeup takeover video, this hair takeover with Coco. I don't know if you saw that video, but a lot of you guys really loved that video. But I also got dozens of comments because Coco had hair down to her waist. She wanted it mid chest or just under the chest. And so we did almost your exact haircut, but a little bit of a longer version for her. And so many of you guys loved it, but there were also a lot of comments being like, it would be great, but she's too old for that cut. Or it would have been better if it was short because she's too old. And I just can't.
The audacity.
I know. And that isn't the thing. And we just have to like stop.
Mm-hmm. Agree. Totally
but if you agree. Feel like your long hair isn't flattering, not because you're old, but maybe it's not flattering for your face shape for whatever reason, mm-hmm. you can keep the length and add the contour. So you're getting kind of the best of both worlds. You're almost getting like a shortcut in a long cut, right?
Do you feel that extension I added in there?
No, I didn't even feel it. Like, don't touch my head.
Be careful. Don't get too close. No. I added a little infinity weft last week.
Oh.
Just to give myself a little bit of.
It looks fabulous.
More volume in the end.
Thank you. Yeah. Okay, let's pull up a community question from the active chat right now. And then we can go back to the community questions in a minute. Let's see what we got, what you guys are asking, what I'm seeing. Oh, sorry. Sorry about that. This is from Diane. Hi, Diane. Thank you for watching. I'm 71, have grown out my hair. I clamp it on the top of my head. Oh, just like Coco. Did you watch Coco's video? I'm going to pin that for you so you can mm-hmm. check it out later. I have a lot of gray hair. I have a heart-shaped face and I need a great haircut that looks good.
Great. Ooh, heart-shaped face. So this way.
Reese Witherspoon.
Yeah.
I love that face.
Does she still want to be able to put it up?
Yeah, Diane. Do you still want to be able to put it up?
Or are you okay cutting it shorter?
You know what? Did you know that a heart-shaped face is the Disney princess face? It's one of the only face shapes that Disney uses to draw princesses.
Why do you think that is?
I think it's because it's very super, super feminine. Tiny chin. Wide cheekbones, big eyes.
Big eyes. I was going to say big, like cartoony eyes.
Yeah, wow. It's a beautiful face shape.
That's one of my favorites. It's one of my favorites. And maybe this is like an old, old, old throwback. But do you know like 1920s Louise Brooks? Like she was famous for doing this really tight bob that sat right at her chin. And she also had a strong fringe. And it's a very hard haircut to wear. But I always think it looks so beautiful in a heart-shaped face. But almost nobody lets me cut it because it's very blunt and but it's beautiful. Google Louise Brooks 1920s.
I would let you cut it if I didn't have a weird chin.
Oh, you don't have a weird chin. You have a beautiful chin. Heart-shaped face. What do you think?
So Diane does want to put it up. Yes, I want to put it up.
Oh. So would you cut a fringe on her? On a heart-shaped face?
Okay, so this is the thing, Diane. I think if you're 71 and you want to wear it up, I think a really great way to keep it long and to have it look really great on your face shape mm-hmm. and to be able, yeah, to have it flatter, I think you should add a fringe. You should yeah. not add a heavy blunt fringe. I think soft. That is going to be
something wispy that sits across her forehead.
Yeah,
maybe like a little bit of shaping in her face here just to show off and compliment her petite little chin. I'm assuming she has.
Yeah.
Those heart shape people do.
Yeah.
So you have like short, wispy fringe, some bits in here, and then add like some shaggy layers in the back, like just to kind of give it volume, give it lift, but you can still put it up.
Yeah, I'm thinking almost like that 1970s aesthetic.
Oh, yeah. totally. A little bit of razor cutting in there.
Yeah, really feathered.
Yes, very soft. And gray, right?
Yeah, she's gray, which is gorgeous.
Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful.
You know what? You know what we'll do? Okay, we're going to get back to these live chats. This is such a great question that I'm going to pull up a presentation that we created with some different haircuts
yeah.
for mature women that are super flattering. And then we can refer to that. Mm-hmm. So I'll say this one. We'll go through them a little bit quickly and then we'll try to pull up some things. So I like to think of haircuts in different I like to conceptualize my haircuts by length. So I always like mid-length, long, bob, pixie, which is a bob and a pixie combined, and then pixie, okay? Any length will work for your age, ladies. There is no rules, right, when it comes to that. So just to reiterate that one more time. So this is considered a mid-length cut with loads of face framing. And as you can see, it's in her natural color. So what are your thoughts on this?
I love that haircut. I think that girl looks so cool. Like, she makes me get excited about being gray.
Yeah.
Like when I see like haircuts like this on women of this age, it makes me get excited about aging.
Yeah.
You know, I would say, like, to what Gabby was talking about when it comes to lengths, I think the most important for me, when somebody sits in my chair, the most important thing I take into consideration is actually has nothing to do with the way they look. It has everything to do with their lifestyle. Yeah. Because, like, you can sit and dissect someone's bone structure and hair texture and come up with a look that works. But at the end of the day, if it's not going to be something that you're going to be able to wear day to day or embrace or work with, then it's really, truly, it's not the best look for you. So the number one thing I like to do is look at somebody's texture and kind of like what length is going to work for them in their lifestyle. Yeah. And then I go in and I look at their bone structure and their shoulders and their height, and we'll kind of tailor something that's going to suit them the best. But those are things I like to take into consideration first.
That's so accurate. And I think something that's so important to talk about, because even for me, for example, I have very textured hair. You guys don't know that because I blow my hair out every single time I wash it. I use really great products. I blow it out with tension, and then I'll go in with another hot tool, whether that's a waver, a curling iron, whatever, right? If I went into Charise's chair, and I know this for a fact, and I told her, I want wash and wear hair, she would never give me this haircut because it looks atrocious when it's air dried.
Picturing it air drying right now.
I had another video go viral where I said, it's me and you in the chair. Yes. And I'm like, what I asked my hairstylist for. And it's like this haircut. And it's like what I got. And it's just my hair air dried. Yeah. And everyone was talking.
People got angry at that. People were so mad.
And that's another thing, right? So much about the haircut that you like is the styling. It's not even really the haircut. And if you don't know how to style it, you have to go to a stylist that's going to give you a cut that's going to work with the texture that you have. That's incredibly important. This haircut would never work for me if I couldn't style it.
Can I give them a little trick I like to do with clients when they bring in inspiration photos? So like maybe we're looking at the other side for people that have photos. They're like, I think they want to try this. What I do is I'll take my phone and a client will pull up a photo of what they want on their phone. And what I'll do is I'll put my thumb over the face. I'll put my thumb over the face and, you know, or I'll zoom it in or I'll kind of black it out. And I'll be like, do you still like that haircut? Because sometimes it's distracting when you're looking at celebrities' faces, right?
Yes.
So it's like, let's cover the face and look at the haircut. Do you still like it? And sometimes they're like, oh, maybe not as much. And it's like kind of an optical illusion.
Totally. Right? Because you're desiring the person's face, not necessarily the cut. Let's pop this one up here before we get into another picture. Hey, Layla. Is highlighting my hair damaging? I love my hair in bob, but my husband hates it. Oh, that's like me. My husband doesn't hate it. He knows better than to tell me that.
Better than to have an opinion about my hair.
He'll always choose long. Always, always.
Get a wig. Put it on in the bedroom. Get adventurous. You can get a good one for $40 on Amazon. That'll do the trick.
That's right. I also love layers, but my hair is straight. Okay, so is highlighting hair damaging?
That's such a loaded question.
No, I don't want to answer it.
I'll answer that question. So there's a short answer and a long answer. So highlighting your hair isn't damage. The act of highlighting your hair, putting bleach on your hair, does do a scientific process to the hair that does lift the cuticle, right, off your hair. If that cuticle is lifted too much or too fast, or not with the proper chemicals, then yes, your hair can feel damaged or over-processed. So the short answer is yes, highlighting does damage hair, but it can actually work to your advantage when we control it. For example, some people that have like very flat cuticle on the outside of their hair, people with a really flat cuticle, their hair can sit really flat. So sometimes they'll add highlights into their hair just to give them more body and more texture to their hair.
Yeah.
So in that case, you're using it to your advantage. If you're concerned about overprocessing and damage, like go see a professional, go see a hairstylist that specializes in blondes and is used to working with bleach every day on different types of hair. And then you'll avoid that.
Yeah, there's a lot of things that have come out in the market now as well that have really helped. Like when I started doing hair, I mean, 18 years ago, we didn't have things like Olaplex, which are basically...
Did you tone hair back then? I didn't even tone hair.
It was like raw bleach. Everyone was like canary yellow.
If they were lucky, they were like the inside of a banana peel. Right? That was like the reference.
If they weren't like lucky, they were like an orange peel.
Yeah, right. It was all fruit-based. For some reason, we referenced food a lot.
That's right. I want to pop this up because this is really, I feel passionate about this because I made a few videos about this that, and some of them have gone viral and I've had a lot of comments about this. So this is Jerry. I've always had fine hair and been told that I had to do some layers. I have a new stylist and I showed her your cut and she thinks it'd work for me. So thanks for freeing me from layers. So Jerry, this is the thing. Let me tell you something about this. Okay. I look like I have an enormous amount of hair. Wouldn't you agree that my strands are quite fine?
Yes. Like you have all these, it's like a dense forest, it's like your natural texture. It's like this, but then these tiny little fine strands of hair. So
yeah, and no one believes me. And I can put, my hair looks super dense because it's
blunt. Girl, that's the power of good product and a good blowout.
I know. Like, and blunt, it's blunt. Mm-hmm. So I can take those baby claw clips that you just put your bangs up in, and I can put my entire head of hair in a baby claw clip. And sometimes I'll do that demo in the videos to show you guys, because I get so much anger in the comments being like, you don't have fine hair. You're not the right person to be talking about this. But you, for one, I had terrible alopecia. I had a hair transplant. I had tons of balding, and trust you me, I do have fine strands. They're very fine. And when you put all my hair together, there really isn't that much of it. But this bluntness, what happens is when you layer hair, so say we were to take all of this hair, okay, and you guys can see I still have a lot of balding in the sides. So you can see how much of my scalp is still present even after the transplant, okay? But say we were to take all of this, right, and we layered it, all of a sudden, look at how wispy my baseline looks. So that was something that I came on here to really advocate and talk about, because there's this thing that you need layers to get volume. If you're fine hair, you need loads of layers. I actually think it's the opposite. I think you need less layers, and you need, if you want to create the illusion of layering, you can do that by detailing the front, but always keeping the baseline as dense as possible. Mm-hmm. And for some people, that means no layers at all. And for others, that means light layering. Like you layered my hair a little bit.
I just like a wee bit, just like a whisper.
Yeah.
A whisper. And to speak to that, I think so many times, you know, like how do we cut volume into hair? I don't think you can. I don't think layers give people volume. I think heat and volumizing products give people volume.
Yeah.
Right. You can have haircuts that will remove weight so your hair is lighter, so it'll easier to give yourself volume. But I also think too, you know, like when you look at a strand of hair, it tapers down into a little point, right?
Yeah.
And then when you cut hair off blunt, you cut it off at the widest diameter of the shaft. So you take all those little hairs and you cut them all blunt to one length. That's when you're going to get the thickest illusion.
Yeah, exactly.
I don't know if that made sense.
No, that totally makes sense. Yeah, Margo said, it does make sense. Okay. Completely. It's like shaving.
Yeah.
When you shave your armpits, it looks like
the hair is growing back thicker. It's not. It's like you shaved off the hair at the widest diameter of the hair shaft.
Exactly. Right? It doesn't grow with the fine line.
Totally.
Okay, Margo's asking, I have an oval face, salt and pepper hair to the mid back side part. It's fine, but lots of it. Yeah, girl, me too. Holds curl well, so I curl it on wash day. Then it's wavy day 2 and 3. I've been thinking about layers.
Oh,
what do you think?
I think you sound like you have amazing hair. Mm-hmm. You sound like I would be careful. I think layers. Does she have thick hair? Did she say that?
Okay, never mind. I don't want layers.
Anyway, in case somebody else has hair similar to hers, layers remove weight from the hair. And when you remove weight from the hair, you're giving space for your hair to move around a little bit more. So if you want your hair to sit controlled in one place, you don't want to overlayer it too much, because all of a sudden you create all this space for the hair to move and do its thing. So if you want your hair to kind of, depending on your hair texture, that could go either way.
Yeah. And think about if you're bored, because I get bored.
Yeah.
And so start doing facial detailing. You don't lose your density. But you can do face frame, loads of face frame. You could do curtain fringe. You could do, there's a really Birkin bang. Birkin bangs are huge this
bottleneck
year.
Bottleneck fringe. I'm like, what other buzzwords? You know, we love a good buzzword.
Right? We got to rank in Google. Throw them out. Butterfly. I want to answer this curly hair question here because so she has curly hair.
I do. You can't tell right now.
Yeah. And my sister goes to her. My sister has extremely curly hair. And you guys know because she's always on the channel. She's got the most beautiful hair I've ever seen.
The best hair.
Yeah. And every time a curly hair question comes up, I'm not the best at answering it because I don't wear my natural texture very often. So curly hair recommendations. I want wash and go. What words should I use with the stylist since they will be new to me? I just get my hair done. And I am afraid. Oh, I understand.
Oh, curly hair recommendations. Well, there's so many different types. I'm always trying to think of the easiest way to answer these questions. Curly hair is beautiful. And I think it depends on the type of curly hair you have. I would say most people that have really tight coily curls, like I think a 3 or 4, if you look at a curly hair, if you have curly hair and you've looked at curly girl hair methods, you know what I say when I say a type 3 or 4 curl.
Yeah.
Those really tight curls, I find people like that with that texture of hair don't get their hair cut that often because it takes so long to get length and it goes 3-dimensionally. And if you cut too much off, it jumps up too high. I would say if you're going for wash and wear hair, I don't know how to answer this question. I'm sorry.
You know
I'm
what?
Struggling because I need to see your hair texture. I'm so sorry. I'm failing right now.
No, you're not failing. You're doing great.
Can we pull up some of those images of those shags?
Yes, we can pull them up.
Yeah.
But I have a suggestion for you.
Yeah. When you're done. Yeah.
Yeah. One of the biggest trends for this year is the curly cut or the round curly cut. Did you guys see that in my 2024 haircut
trend report?
Yeah. Trend report. So it's not. It's not like a normal long haircut with layers cut in. The entire thing is cut rounded. So if you want wash and go, what's that that's telling me is you don't ever want to wear it straight, right? Or am I assuming? Because if you don't ever want to wear it straight, I would cut it with a curly hair specialist and cut it in a curly form. Mm-hmm. Those round cuts are beautiful. Oh,
stunning. Yes, that's a great question. If you have really curly hair and you never wear it straight, you always wear your hair curly, you want to see a hairstylist that's comfortable cutting dry curly hair. They know how to work with form and shape a little bit more than somebody that's going to blow dry it out, flat iron it, and cut it dry, which some hairstylists do.
Yeah.
Right? And then you kind of lose all those like wave pattern inconsistencies, and it becomes really hard to measure the juxtaposition of curls in the hair and all those types of things.
Yeah, because cutting curly hair, like, and I say this with all respect because I love curly hair. I have curly hair, not that I wear it curly because my hair is like a fuzzball, but my sister's hair is beautiful and it's curly, but it's like trimming a hedge. Like, it's very different than cutting because straight hair, you're cutting with a lot of angles and the angles are creating the drop, which is creating the fold. And it's about like elevation and over directing. But I find curly hair, you almost have to cut it into the shape that you want it because the way that the curls form, like if you cut mid curl, it springs up weird. And that's assuming if she has very curly hair, but I would definitely go to a very curly hair specialist. Yeah. Why don't we pull up some cuts?
Yeah, let's do that.
Cuts are very inspiring.
I'm sorry. I didn't give the best answer, but
that was a great answer. Don't be hard.
I'm going to go home. I need to keep it. It's going to come to me in the night.
Well, you guys, are you loving Charise? We have so many people actively online right now. Tell me how much you love her in the chat so we can build up her confidence. She's doing so great.
Thanks, guys.
Okay, let's talk a little bit about this mid-length cut. What are your thoughts on this one?
Oh, I love it. It's beautiful. You know what this is? This is like, you know how fashion trends evolve and change and grow? I'm all about, one thing I always say is inspiration, not replication, right? Yeah. So we can take inspiration from the past and we can, instead of replicating it, we can do it in a little bit of a modern way. And this says Jennifer Aniston in the 90s.
Yeah,
that layered haircut was so like the 90s version of viral, whatever that is. Like everybody wanted it. It was like viral. I mean, viral didn't exist, but you know what I mean? Yes. And I feel like this is a great 2024 version of something like that. It's got lots of bounce, shape.
Yeah.
It's beautiful on her.
I know. I love it too. And look, everyone's loving you so much right now.
Oh, thanks everybody.
I love her honesty. Aw, yeah. I love her honesty.
I'm not bad. I'm not good at not being honest. I'm a pretty blunt to the point person.
I know. That's what I appreciate about you.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
I love this cut too. The only, my only apprehension with this cut, it looks fabulous on her. It really chisels out and carves out her face, really softens her features. Not that she has much to soften because she's beautiful, but this is a cut that requires quite a bit of styling.
100%.
Yeah.
This is not going to wash and wear well.
Yeah.
I also feel like the top is a little bit heavy. Like if on the right, I would have just went through and went a little bit more in there. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Because the layers are quite short compared to the, the baseline's very weak there. Mm-hmm.
That this is for somebody who has a blowout brush and loves using their blowout brush.
Yes. A good set of Velcro rollers, right?
And a preach.
All right. Let's go on to our next picture. Okay. So what I'm noticing right now is that 2024 is loving the heavily face framed cut. Mm-hmm. What do you think of this one?
I think it, this to me looks like a very similar to the last haircut, just on finer hair.
Yeah.
So if you have, if you liked the last haircut that was up, but you have finer hair, this is probably a little bit more accurate to what it would look like on you. And for this, you're definitely want to get a good volumizing product and round brush and go to town.
Yeah. Do you guys feel comfortable using a round brush or a blow up brush? Let me know in the comment section, because that's essential, I think, to achieve almost any of the looks that are trending right now.
Actually, can I take a second to talk about product right now?
100%.
Okay. So while we're looking at this photo, I brought this with me. This is my most favorite volumizing product to use on my more mature clients. It's the Aveda Femolian. I don't know if you can see that there.
I'll get her in frame.
What I love, what I like about this is it's
going to block your face.
It's okay. We've got a lot going on here. And you can also message me on Instagram and I can send you a link to this product. But it's Femolian. It's by Aveda. And what I like about it, it performs like a mousse, but there's no alcohol in it. So it's not going to dry your hair out. You can pump it.
Yeah, let's try.
Yeah, it's like a foam. Like it's a non-aerosol.
You guys see that?
Right. And what I like to do is put, it also has a nice shine to it. So especially if you're somebody that's embracing their gray hair, this is going to add some nice shine to it. It's super, super, super lightweight. All my clients with fine hair, it's actually great on thick hair. It's great on all hair textures, but it is really, really lightweight. And it adds a nice amount of hold and shine, and it smells great.
And it's not sticky.
Yeah, it's a little bit, but not too sticky.
Yeah, that's right? Awesome.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to go get a towel, but can you tell them what you told me? You guys, we had the best conversation earlier about products, the stick.
Explain slip and grip.
Yeah,
I would love to explain slip and grip to y'all right now. So what is slip and grip? Slip and grip is a phrase I like to use when it comes to picking out products. So Gabby and I were talking about products earlier yesterday about some of you had asked in the community questions beforehand the best products to use on your hair. And instead of like sharing specific products with you, although I did bring some of my faves, my go-tos, I wanted to like empower you to be able to make the selection on your own. So a rule of thumb is when you take a product like Gabby just did, if you want to find out how it's going to perform on your hair, apply it to your skin. So for example, this foam, I would pump it on my skin and I would feel it. So you can use this if you're in your bathroom at home and you have products and you're like, should I use this? Shouldn't I? Put it on your skin and feel it. So you'll put product on your skin. I'll do a little dot here. We have this towel handy.
Yeah, we have the towel handy.
So if I wanted to know what this product was doing on my hair, I put it on my skin. I'd massage it in, wave it around, tap it a little bit. And if it feels like there's a little bit of a tackiness to it, a little bit of stick, I know that that product is going to give me hold and it's going to help expand my hair because it has a little bit of grip. Alternatively, and so that would be a great option, a product that's grippy, that has a little bit of stick, is going to be a great option for something that's going to hold your hair, hold your blowout, hold your curls, as well as make your hair expand and feel fuller. On the contrary, products that are slippery, hair oils, serums, I brought one of my favorite serums by Aveda, the Light Element Smoothing Fluid. If I pump this directly on my skin and massage it in, it's going to feel really slippery and really silky. Fun fact, if I'm going out in the summertime and I'm wearing a mini skirt, I'll actually take like a hair pomade or a smoothing fluid and I'll put it directly on my calves because then the light reflects on them and it makes them look really nice and toned.
Just as much on my legs in the summer.
Yeah, I get right in there. Fun fact.
Can I see it? Yeah,
totally. Pump it on yourself. So the light elements, so products like that are more slippery, you know, when you put them on your hair, it's going to shrink your hair. It's going to feel very soft. So slippery products are great for frizz. If you've got a wiry hair, if you've got thick hair and you don't want it to get too poofy, products that are slippery are going to help shrink it and make them feel silkier and softer. Grippy products are going to do the opposite.
That's a great tip. It actually flipping so grip. Accurate.
Yeah.
So Brenna just said, I'm struggling with my products. I'm letting my hair go naturally gray. Yes, you are. Woo! Yeah, go girl. I love that movement right
yes.
now.
Yeah.
My hair looks frizzy. I believe I have normal hair. I can go a couple days, but it just looks frizzy as the day goes on. What would you suggest for that?
I would say when you're, does she wash and wear?
Brenda, do you wash and wear?
Okay. Well, if you wash and wear your hair, what I would suggest is actually put something with a little bit more hold on your hair when it's wet. And I would, instead of just like scrunching it or just brushing it and let it air dry, I would actually loosely twist your hair into big sausage curls. I find hair that tends to expand and get puffy. If you can set it when it's wet a little bit more by condensing it down, like take big sections and twist them and let them air dry, they're going to dry in a little bit more of a conformed manner. Does that make sense what I'm saying?
Yeah, that makes sense. And yes, she does want to wash.
Yeah. So yeah. I would put something like even like a little bit of a foam, like something like that. I would also use a leave-in conditioner for hydration, which brings me to my next point when it comes to talking about product. You know, we've determined whether products have slip or grip. And maybe you need both because there are people that do need a leave-in conditioner. If you're heat styling your hair, if you're lightening your hair, you're processing it, or maybe you've noticed you're growing your gray hair and it feels a little bit more drier, a little bit more coarse, you might want to use a product for hydration. And most of those products are going to be slippery. So what I would do is I would layer that on your hair first, because when your hair, after it's shampooed and conditioned, it's freshly cleaned, it's going to absorb the first thing you put on your hair. So whatever product you want the most performance out of, which is usually a leave-in conditioner, or something for hydration, that's what you want to put on your hair first. And then if you want something for hold to control it, or maybe you want to put something for hold in your hair before you blow dry it, then I would layer that on top. So I would maybe start with my leave-in conditioner, and then I would layer my grippy product like my mousse or my foam over top of that so that it doesn't absorb into the hair quite like the leave-in conditioner.
That's a great tip.
Thanks.
Because sometimes I even think about if I need... because I do need smoothing because I also have texture, but I also need volume. Yeah. And sometimes I think about that as well. Like, how can I cocktail this in the yes. best possible way?
So start with like nutrients and health, and that's leave-in conditioner. Those are designed to nourish and soak into your hair yeah. and give it some love. And then you like put the volumizing sprays and texture tonics and boom, 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 and go for it.
Yeah. Bailey just said, oh my God, that's great info. And it is great info. We're getting to your questions today. We are hitting it with you guys. So let's pop up the pictures again, because I know these really inspire you. So let's go on to our next one. I want to get through some of these mid-length ones, but then I also want to get through some of the longer ones. So let's go here. Oh my
God,
Brenda, right? Brenda.
I just want to like look like her. Like, I want her face. I want her hair. What a babe.
She is beautiful.
But I think this is kind of like that round shape you were talking about,
exactly.
right? Like there's no corners. It's that perfect round silhouette. It looks really beautiful on her.
So the thing with this cut that I've really been researching and studying, I'm not a curly hair specialist. So I don't want to pretend to be, but it's actually so heavily layered in the middle of the head that the base, there isn't a solid baseline. Mm. So it's phenomenal. If you air dry, you absolutely have to go to a curly hair specialist for this.
Yeah, it's very forgiving, and this haircut will grow out really nicely too.
Yes, yeah. But it will not work if you straighten it. Okay, it's going to look like a choppy, disastrous mess.
100%.
But Brenda does love it. I hope that helped you, Brenda. I hope that answered your question.
Beautiful.
Okay, yeah. Let's get to our next one. Oh my goodness. Another mid-length cut. Mm-hmm. This is beautiful too. Exact same
gorgeous.
Thing. Heavily
yeah.
layered in the front.
Yeah, she just looks like she's got really healthy, shiny hair. What I like about this is that front part hangs down a little bit longer. It sweeps really nicely on her face. This would be a great option for somebody that also likes to tie their hair back and get their hair out of their face, because that long layer, that layer in the front is a little bit longer.
Yes.
So if your lifestyle is someone who's a little bit more active, you like to go to the gym, you like to get all your hair to your face, this would be a great option, because it's not, you still get the illusion of all those layers in the ends and the back, but it's not too short around your face. You could still
Totally. You know what? While we're on here, let's actually talk a little bit about products for gray. So Layla just wrote, I use a milkshake whipped cream leave-in foam. Okay, hold on, hold on. Give me a second. So I used to sell, when I had my studio, you guys, I used to sell milkshake in studio, and I'm almost out of product. Have you ever tried milkshake?
I have tried milkshake. Yes, it's they've got some great stuff. I haven't used all of their stuff, but...
So the milkshake line is all about like soft, natural hair. Are you going to get mind-blowing Alterna volume mousse volume? Absolutely not. Mm-hmm. If you want pretty girl next door soft hair, it's a great line. It smells amazing, gives you very soft, pretty hair. I don't find that you're going to get crazy blow dry results.
I see it. I won't spray it. You can spray it.
No,
silver shine.
So that's why I wanted to talk about this, because we were just talking about the silver or the white hair.
Do you find this helps keep the hair from going yellow too?
Yes.
Okay.
Because it's very light. I haven't used this in so. Oh, see.
That, it looks like I want to eat it. Like I'm not going to, but I thought
I'm smell it. I know. So this one has, it's blueberry based. Okay. So this one has a very, very light kind of bluish purple tinge. So as you guys know, when you're white, especially if you have white, very fine hair, that hair scorches, like you put a flat iron on it and it turns yellow. Mm-hmm. It's brutal. Mm-hmm.
Clean your hot tools and replace them often. If that coating is coming off, that's a good time to replace it. Cause that'll
totally,
you know, great time to check in your hot tools. Yeah. I find when I plant their hair, it's going, their gray hair is going too yellow. I'm like, let's take inventory. Are your plates in good shape? Your flat iron, your curling iron, right?
That's a really good point, actually, because there's so many comments and complaints about that. Mm-hmm. And it could be just an old hot tool situation.
Totally. I find people don't replace their hot tools enough. You know, when you look at your flat iron and the plates are that ceramic coating is scratching off.
Yes.
Then you have just that straight iron against the hair. And then it deposits all sorts of different metal minerals on your hair. And it will make your hair go yellow. So grab a new hot tool. The other thing when it comes to purple and blue hair products.
Yes.
Tell me. I love purple and blue hair products. And when I say purple and blue, some product lines will call them purple, some of them will call them blue, but essentially it's that pastel-y, bluey, violet tone that Gabby just showed in the mousse. You want to be, I find products like that, that they have a little bit of a direct dye in them, right?
Yes.
Right? You want to be careful with products with direct dyes in them because they do have a little bit more of an acidic pH to them. So they will dry your hair out if you do overuse them.
100%.
So one thing I like to use, again, it's another Aveda product. I carry mostly Aveda. So this is what I have on hand. But this is their Color Renewal Shine Mask. So what this is, it's like it's a mask that you would replace your conditioner with. Right.
Okay.
So like any hair mask you would put on your hair, you can open it up.
Yeah.
Like any hair mask.
Yeah.
Go for it, girl. Get in there.
You're on my show.
Get in there. So like any hair mask and like a conditioning hair mask, it's designed to hydrate your hair. Most hair masks. So this one has a purple tint to it, just like the silver one, but it isn't. It's going to put a little bit more shine on your hair. It's not going to dry your hair. It has a lot more ingredients in there to balance out the acidity of the direct dyes. There aren't a lot of those over-the-counter, really rich pigmented blue shampoos and conditioners. We love a rich pigment. It does what it's supposed to do in regards to color, but you also sacrifice a little bit of hair health.
I'm going to leave all of these products linked for you guys in the description box. Mm-hmm. You're going to have to give me until tomorrow because the live stream ends late.
Yeah.
It's hard for Lori and I. You guys always hear me talk about Lori. One day I'm going to bring her on camera because she is my right hand on this channel. She does so many things for me. So she's going to pull up links from if Charise sells them on her website.
Yeah, I'll
find other links. Yeah, so that you guys can see it. And I talked again about the Alterna volume mousse. Is it good for volume? Absolutely. Mm-hmm. It's amazing. It's my favorite volume mousse. It has terrible reviews on the Sephora website. I have absolutely no idea why. It will give you Texas hair. Like, it will take you
one.
To heaven with the hair.
This one in a long time.
Girl, you love it.
Like, I'm going to be shopping after work. I'm going to be going on like Sephora after this and boop, boop, boop.
Yeah. It,
we all are.
It's drying, but it's big. Okay? It's big.
Look, sometimes you just need to get the job done.
Yeah. But the Aveda products, I find that they are just so, I mean, it's exceptional quality. It's another level of quality.
Totally. It's like luxury. It like, you know, if you need something like that, you can, but there are also lots of other options out there too. So
yeah. And we'll leave them in the description box for you guys. If you check back tomorrow, they should be there so that you can go shopping. Okay. So, oh, I want to say something else about purple shampoo before we go on. Another thing I want to tell you is something that I get asked a lot from clients, and purple shampoo will neutralize yellow, right? Blue shampoo will neutralize orange. Mm-hmm. But if there's nothing left to neutralize, it will turn your hair lilac or a faint hint of blue.
Have you ever done that to yourself?
No, I've never been light enough, but I have absolutely done that to clients. And I've had a lot of clients have that issue because sometimes, especially very, 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 very blonde clients, when they're doing on the scalp lightener, their roots will be slightly more yellow than their mid shafts and ends. And they'll go crazy with the purple shampoo. And what will end up happening is that the roots suddenly look very yellow.
Yeah, because you never get the roots light enough to match their, so they need to bleach back their hair every time.
Yes. And it's an issue with overusing the product. So there's this thing that we refer to in the industry. I'm going to tell you, it's so inappropriate. It's called blonderexia, when you never think you're blonde enough.
Like, I have a few of those.
Don't we all?
Don't we all?
There's always more yellow. There's always yellow. I need lighter, lighter, lighter. Yeah. And they go ham on the purple shampoo. And then they come into the salon, they're mad at you because they're like, you turned my hair lilac. And it's like, did you wash with purple shampoo 6 times this week?
Yeah. You're like, I can't have turned, you can't turn people. Yeah, no.
So be careful with your purple shampoo. You guys
use as needed, not regularly. That's
exactly.
What I would say. Use as needed.
It's a treatment. It's not a day-to-day shampoo. And it's also very, very drying. Mm-hmm. Okay. So let's get this photo back up here. Okay. Let's go on to our next one.
Oh, I love this look.
So I know. We're like, oh,
so beautiful.
Tell me, what do you see? What do you think?
I think this is a very realistic photo for somebody that has curly hair that's not too curly. So if you're somebody who has like naturally wavy hair, I think this is a great haircut for people that don't know. Like maybe you're somebody who's thinks you have a little bit of, like when you go on vacation, you go swimming and your hair air dries and you're like, oh, I have a little bit of wave in my hair.
Yes.
But you're used to heat styling your hair all the time and you've never like embraced it. This is a great way to start embracing it. I
yeah.
do a little bit of like a sea salt spray in there.
Totally. It's beautiful. And it can be disheveled. This is kind of like a modern shag.
Yeah. Right? A lot of people are doing this right now.
It's very,
it's very hot in 2023. I think you're going to see this come into 2024.
Yeah, me too. Hello girls. Hi, Sylvia. I have wavy, thin, frizzy gray hair. Stopped dyeing my hair 5 years ago. Yeah, you did.
Woo!
I want to know what is the best haircut for me, straight or layered?
Ooh, thin, frizzy, gray hair. I would cut into bob with a little bit of a layer in it.
Yeah.
Yeah. What do you think?
I agree. If it's thin, so thin hair, we always think of it's like building a puzzle. Mm-hmm. Thin, we got to take up the length.
Yeah.
Or else it looks too thin.
Yes.
Right? Frizzy, we need to embrace the texture somehow. Mm-hmm. So I think we need to get some of those layers in so that you can create almost texture instead of just frizz.
Also, you don't want to get a lampshade.
Exactly.
If you have a bit of wave in there. Does she wave? Or am I just looking at that?
Yeah, wavy. Okay. Wavy yes. hair.
Okay, yes.
So you could do a beautiful lob. Mm-hmm. Right? A lob would be beautiful. That's a lob, if you don't know, it's a long bob. So it's a collarbone length bob mm-hmm. with some light layering and texturizing. If your hair is frizzy and wavy, I would avoid a fringe for sure.
Yes, I would definitely avoid a fringe.
Yeah.
Maybe keep it long enough that you might be able to tuck it behind your ear if you're a tucker.
Yes.
I know, like, that's kind of, yeah.
Yeah.
But I think a lob, a nice blunt lob with a little bit of layering.
Yeah, let's see if we can get, these are all so pretty. These are all quite similar. Yes. Now we're getting into the long vibe. This is Charise's hair. This is your hair.
Yeah.
Right? We're seeing a lot of that. It's beautiful. Here's a long version. Do you want to talk a little bit about this type of fringe? Because I think this is so flattering on mature faces.
Yes. And what I love about this fringe is you have the structure of a full fringe, meaning you get that full forehead coverage that I know some women like, as you know, it just softens aging skin or maybe thinning brows or all those things as we age we're, you know, adjusting to. I feel like it has the practicality of a full fringe in that result, but doesn't sit heavy on the hair. So it's really nice and wispy in the center. The key to this is having it cut properly, because if this fringe is done properly, it should actually grow out with your haircut. Mm-hmm. It shouldn't be high maintenance. You shouldn't need to go in for bang trims or fringe trims too regularly, because it'll just grow out with, like, see how the the corners of the fringe around her eye connect into her layers quite beautifully there. So you don't really know where the haircut ends and the fringe or the bangs. Do you call fringe or bangs?
I call it fringe, but the Canadian way is to
say I call fringe, but then I'm like, wait, who am I speaking to? Yes. Fringe or bang, whatever you want to call it. We mean the same thing. So it's cut well enough that you get these like wispy fringe in the forehead, and it kind of just connects in with the haircut quite lovely.
Yeah, love it. Do we have another audience question? Why don't we pull up another audience question while we're on this one? Okay, great. So it says, sorry guys, I can't read because there we go. Hi, I have fine hair. What do you recommend for volume? Also looking for a good hairstyle. Have shoulder length hair. You're looking for a good hairstylist. Any salon you recommend? Okay, this is tough because it depends on where in the world you are. Mm-hmm. But we were actually having this conversation recently because there was another question in the community board about how do you find your Charise?
Where do you
so
start?
Hard. Yeah. What do you think?
So I think the most underrated service that any reputable salon will provide is something called a consultation. And they'll provide this to you for free. So what I would do is, especially if you're in a new area, like somebody I think on the community board had mentioned how they'd moved to a new city. So what I would do is get on Google and research. If you don't have anybody, word of mouth, is Google and look at those top salons and book consultations at all of them. And when you call them to book your consultation, ask them for somebody who's a little bit more experienced. If you're nervous, right? If you're one of those people who's like, go for it, I'm okay being like, you know, a guinea pig, go see like somebody who's brand new. But what I would do is research the salons, book a consultation at a few of them with a hairstylist. And at that consultation, ask them questions, have them look at your hair, ask them based on what I've told you, what do you think I should do? And see what they tell you. If you're not vibing with them, you'll know right away when you're sitting in someone's chair. I can tell really quickly if I'm going to get along with somebody or not in a negative way, but if our energies are going to connect. And so if you don't like that salon's vibe or that stylist vibe, you know, you're just going to go on to a new place. But consultations are underrated. And then when you find that hairstylist, if they pull it off, maybe if they've sold you, you're going to be in the chair, maybe don't do a big dramatic change with your first time with the hairstylist. Let them get to know your hair a little bit first. Have them trim it up. Have them do something that's pretty forgiving, longer layers, depending on the length of hair you have, before you fully jump into bed with them right away. Build that trust, date them a little bit. You want to go on a few dates, see if they're the one. And then, you know, you want to change your hair, go from brunette to blonde, long to short, jump into bed with them, baby, all the way. You've built that trust. Yes. Use protection.
Oh, that's Olaplex, if you don't know.
Yeah. The condom of the hair world. Yeah. Ribbed. Sorry.
That's just such good advice. And I get this question so often too. You guys, finding a hairstylist, Charise and I were just saying this before we went live. It's like finding a husband. It's like finding a boyfriend.
Finding the one.
Right. Not only do you need the same aesthetic, visual aesthetic, you need to be kind of into the same look. So if someone's, for example, I'm not at all edgy. Like I had like a total nervous breakdown when I got this huge tattoo. I still regret it to this day. Like,
I saw that. I didn't know you had that.
I do. Yeah. I have a large, anyway.
Who is it?
It's a whole thing. It actually represents all of the women who I've helped to feel beautiful.
Love that. Love that. Okay,
yeah. Cool. I'll show you guys.
Sorry, Gabby didn't, we didn't want to talk. Yeah.
But with that, that's an aside. I'm not edgy at all, other than this tattoo that totally freaks me out that I've wanted to get lasered, but I'm too scared. But it's I'm more classic, right? So if I go to the stylist who does tons of fashion colors and razor cuts and mullets and crazy shags, like that's not my vibe. She might be able to do a really classic bob, but she might not even really want to, you know. As a stylist, being someone that loves Victoria's Secret hair. Every client I had in my chair from all those years of being a stylist wanted to look like a Victoria's Secret model. I did not have a single edgy girl. Could I do rainbow hair? For sure. Technically I could do it, but you need to like vibe with your style. Like you guys need to be like one with your aesthetic so that they get you, you get them.
Huge.
And personality, you need to like them. It's a lot of time that you spend with them.
Yeah.
So you want to just really like them. Okay. Is it true if you trim your hair, it grows faster.
No.
No.
No, it doesn't. What people, I think if you trim your hair regularly, you're going to prevent your split ends from taking off, which means when you get your hair cut, you're not going to have to cut as much. So if you're somebody who goes in for a haircut once a year and you want it to be healthy, you're probably going to have to cut more off than if you went in for regular trims and just cut off the dead bits. So it doesn't make your hair grow faster. It'll just keep the hair you have on your head longer.
Think about it like pantyhose. Yeah. You get a little snip in your pantyhose. If you don't, I mean, you can't repair pantyhose, but say you keep wearing it, it goes zzz, and the next thing you know, your whole pantyhose is destroyed and it happens like that. Mm-hmm. Split ends are the same way. Mm-hmm. Totally. So if you don't get them taken off, they'll zip up and then you end up with so much breakage. Mm-hmm. You guys will know if you have breakage that's happening. If you find little bits of hair, when you brush your hair, if there's little bits of hair in your sink or on your floor and you're like, what is it? They're like little short bits mm-hmm. of hair, almost like dandruff hair.
Totally.
Yeah. That's, then you'll know that's breakage. Your hair snapping off. That shouldn't happen.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. You book a haircut.
Book a haircut.
Trim haircut.
That's right. Okay, let's do a couple more of these because these are really fun.
I love them. Beautiful.
Right? Same kind of thing. Yes.
That fringe connects into the haircut beautifully. Yeah. It'll grow out really nice.
If you guys like these, screenshot them, okay? And you can catch the replay. So if you're not being able mm-hmm. to get them now, you can screenshot them later. This woman's mm-hmm. so stunning. I'm not loving the fringe version part of this cut. I think it could do more for her. But mm-hmm. I like the face frame a lot. Mm-hmm. Yeah, these are just some.
Yeah, beautiful. I love that. That's like a great way to incorporate a fringe. Again, like I said earlier, it's not a high maintenance fringe. It's wispy. It sits full forehead without being too aggressive and too heavy.
Yeah. And this is a really interesting color. Do you want to talk? You know what we should talk about? But I think you guys, we're almost out of time, you guys, but we have to talk about this. It's gray blending. What do you do when you start going gray and you have color and you are over coloring it?
You want me to answer that?
Yes.
I tell my clients, there's two ways you can go about this. There's an easy way and there's a faster way. So if you're somebody who's been coloring their hair and doing full opaque gray coverage, and you're like, I've had enough. I don't want this line anymore in my hair. I want to go natural. My advice to you is to grow your roots as long as you can stand it. So get a good few inches in there and go see a hairstylist that is comfortable with gray blending. So I would book a partial foil and I would get highlights and lowlights, because at your first first appointment, you want to diffuse that line. So when you have a solid hair color and it grows in, like mine is a solid color and it grows out, to blend that line, you want to diffuse it. And so foil does that because it adds dimension into it, right? And that's called gray blending, right? Another option you could do would be to, instead of using a solid permanent hair color that gives 100% gray coverage, you could use something that's called a demi-permanent that blends your grays. And it's the difference of going back to your pantyhose analogy, using it in a different way though. Think of permanent hair color as like your solid opaque Lululemon legging, right? And then your demi-permanent is like that sheer pantyhose, right? So it's like putting like a filter on your hair versus covering it. The other way that you could do is
brilliant.
The other way is, I don't know if you, do you follow Jack Martin on Instagram? He does a lot of celebrity transfer. I'll send you some of his stuff. Okay. So I don't know if you guys see these like little viral clickbaity things. It's like when women come in with their natural hair color, salt and pepper, and then he color corrects it, blends it to match. Like he'll do these 10-hour color corrections where essentially he removes all the color in their hair and matches the salt and pepper density in somebody's hair. That's a major color correction. You don't want to go see anybody for just that. But somebody did it with Sharon Osbourne. She went gray for a little bit and then she hated it and went back to coloring her hair dark. But lots of different ways. But partial foil or a demi-permanent hair color instead of a permanent hair color.
That's a great tip. And I never, ever heard anyone suggest that, because then what you're essentially going to do is you're putting a little Band-Aid on the situation.
Yes.
And so it's not such an abrasive thing instead of going through all the, because you guys, there's no way around it. If you have dark brown colored hair and you have white and gray coming in to get it to lift to a level 10 and then tone it a super cool color, there is a lot of damage. It doesn't even matter who does it. It's going to be very damaging.
It's not going to look silver.
Yes.
It's like, yeah.
It will be a huge challenge.
Yeah, 100%.
So, I mean, if you go to someone who specializes in it, for sure, you have a much better chance of having a good result. But doing a demi color is a great idea because then you put that demi brown on top. You're blurring and blending it out and you're buying time.
Yes, you are. And then when it becomes time to do a big chop, a big haircut and cut all the rest of the colored ends off.
Yeah.
I have quite a few clients that have embraced their natural color. They've gone gray and then they're like, oh, it almost feels like a little too white or a little too silver, but they don't want to go back to coloring their hair. So oftentimes what I'll do is I'll pick a tone that will complement them. So either like a beigey blonde or a coppery blonde, right? Yeah. And I'll put little sprinkles of it in their hair with baby lights. And it's something that it's like no maintenance hair color. They can really grow it out or they can maintain it as often or as little as they want. And it just adds a little flex of light and dimension in there.
Yeah, that's right? So pretty.
Yeah.
My friend Justin Hickox, you guys know him, the creator Justin Hickox, we did a collab together and he had a client with naturally white hair and he actually added black highlights and I was so scared.
Yeah, we talked about that.
Yeah, I was like, like I'm literally being like, she's going to hate it. I'm like seeing him painting. I'm like, what?
Like one end on gray hair.
Literally.
I grow up.
I was like having like heart palpitations. It was even my client, but it looked phenomenal because what he did is he added pepper in salt and pepper. She only had salt. He added the pepper. He added that spice.
Yeah. Somebody's going to need black pepper. Somebody's going to do a little bit of turmeric, a little cayenne.
a little level eight pepper.
Yeah. Level eight pepper. But, you know, it did look beautiful. So
it did look beautiful. Okay. You guys, we have, those highlights were stunning. I remember that one. Yeah, Glenda. I mean, tell me about it. Okay, so little announcement, and then we're going to get to one more question. I'm going to a creator house in April. You guys, I've mentioned this a few times. I'm going to a creator house in the States. Justin Hickox is going to be there. Angie from Hot and Flashy is going to be there. Allie Glines is going to be there. Marlena Stell, Lisa J Makeup. Nikki LaRose is going to be there. Penn Smith Skincare. We're going for 4 days. We're creating content for 4 straight days in this creator house. If you guys want to see specific content made with those people, like they are incredible creators. I'm so honored and blessed to be able to be a part of that experience.
That is so cool.
Congrats.
Gabby.
That's for me. Yeah. But if you guys want to see things, we're actually going through a lot of meetings right now to conceptualize what we're going to be talking about. And as you know, I make content for you, specifically tailored to you and your needs and what are you worried about and things that you guys struggle with. So if there's something that you're like, girl, talk to Angie about this, let me know, because I will bring that into our creator meetings. And then you can watch the actual videos that you requested in the comment section. So please, please do that if you have a chance. And let's pop up one more question. As we get that question up, you guys, if you are enjoying this live stream, don't forget to give me a thumbs up. That really helps the channel grow. And also definitely follow Charise on Instagram. I'm going to post her Instagram on the pinned comment. Okay. Cause she's like extraordinarily hilarious and you will love her content. Can you tell them what your Instagram is?
Charise Juanita. That's C-H-A-R-I-S-E. J-U-A-N-I-T-A.
There will be a quiz later.
Yeah, totally. Like, yeah.
Okay. This last question here. Can you use a purple product and then use a moisturizing conditioner? Or does that defeat the point?
Nope, not at all. You could use a purple or blue or purple shampoo and then use a hydrating hair mask, any conditioner as well to balance it. Yeah, people do that all the time.
Yeah. That's perfect.
Yeah.
You guys, thank you so much for coming on. I'm always so honored that all of you guys come on and thank you so much for coming.
Oh, thanks for having me. You guys have been so fun. It's been great seeing some of the little messages and comments. It's been a blast. And slide into my messages over on Instagram if you have any questions about, you know, anything we talked about today. Thank you so much for having me, Gabby.
I don't want to say that, Charise.
Oh, no. Again.
You guys. She's a part of the glam fam. If you want her back, let me know in the comment section below. I will like weasel her back into the studio. I think you were
an amazing guest. I'm starstruck in this space. It's amazing. So I'll come back in this loft anytime.
Yeah, in my loft. All right, you guys, this was awesome. Thank you. Oh, you guys, I love you so much. I'll catch you in the next one.
Thank you.
Bye.